Services run that.
So you run this academy?
Yes,
through?
Yes.
Okay, train.
Yes.
Okay, please be seated. Please be seated.
So, welcome to all the aspirants from KingMakers Academy. You're very fortunate to have an interaction with one of the icons of India. And we are very fortunate to say that we are part of the team headed by Madam here. And I'm Additional Secretary to Madam. And it's a very fortunate opportunity to you all. But when we prepared, we didn't get this opportunity. But now you are getting. Kindly interact and you will get a lot. And we are getting every day motivated towards doing better things. Thank you. Madam, can
you see?
So, some more things.
Good afternoon, everybody. And our highly respected Her Excellency, Ma'am Dr. Kiran Bedi, a source of inspiration. You might be aware, much information about ma'am, you know, that that brought you here. The first women IPS officer, crusaded all kind of reforms in police administration. With gut feeling, you know, you might be aware, the pillar to the post, the transfer, and when she entered Tihar jail, that got transformed. So the tendency of the punishment should not be punitive, rather it should be curative or reformative. Ma'am initiated the characteristic feature of industrial society, especially post-industrial society, from Tihar jail. For a long time, you know, that when we were preparing for civil service examination, Ma'am Dr. Kiran Bedi, she has become a subject matter for us, you know, part of current affairs. We come to know about ma'am when she was awarded the Ramon Magsaysay Award for the community service, especially with reference to Tihar jail reforms. And beyond that, you know, her participation in the police administration took her to the level of the Interpol organization. And whether the role of, you know, tennis player or social activist or top super cop, so it is, she chose, you know, that we are as voluntary retirement service. So from the position of, you know, DGP, became social activist, you might be aware, India Against Corruption Movement. So that could produce, you know, that few leaders, the topmost, you know, that inspiring leadership by Dr. Kiran Bedi, Her Excellency, you know, that no wonder at all. Every day it is inspiring us. We follow her through, you know, that Twitter, Facebook, everyday inspiration, the good morning message. It's a nutrition, ma'am. So we get inspiration from you. We all, you know, that the students, you know, that benefiting out of your good morning nutrition. Yeah, really, ma'am. Definitely. Even today. So this prompted us, you know, to tweet every day morning. So say good morning along with, you know, that the ma'am's, you know, presence, you know, that it's not only the Prime Minister of India, the President of India, the ma'am is one among my favorite to say good morning. I don't know whether she follows or not in the Twitter. So coming back to this, you know, the Puducherry administration, of course, Yatha Raja Tata Sanstan, the character of the institution is getting reflected in leadership. So ma'am, Dr. Kiran Bedi, your character is getting reflected in Puducherry. All kind of initiatives you took here, whether it is, you know, green Puducherry or rejuvenation of all those water bodies and making, you know, that self-sufficient, you know, waters, especially with increase of ground table in Puducherry and various initiatives we come to know. Ma'am, you know, that we really wonder, actually you are walking in the path of, you know, that we believe Dr. Kalam. So the Rashtrapati Bhavan that has become, you know, People's Bhavan there, we see Raj Nivas is no more Raj Nivas, it's People's Nivas here. It's because of you. And we admire in the world of IT, the mass connector role played by Steve Jobs, connecting different elements so as to make wonderful product. For that, you know, we remember even today Steve Jobs. So coming to India, the People's President, Dr. Kalam, connecting everybody, whether he was part of the scientific establishment, even in political, of course, the executive administration, he did mass connecting role. The same way, what ma'am is doing, Her Excellency Dr. Kiran Bedi ma'am is doing, the corporate social responsibility, it's not blaming the system. We should not be part of the blaming game. in spite of all the difficulties, whatever may be the area, the ma'am once entered Puducherry, it acquired a different attention. He connected the people. Again, mass connector role played by Dr. Kiran Bedi ma'am, speaking in that way, the corporate social responsibility, the issue, recognizing issues, when the very administration, Union Territory Administration, running short of resources, connecting with sponsors under CSR, and she has become part of the solution. So after your selection as IAS, IPS officers, you're going to be part of, you know, Bharat Darshan. You're going to visit various leaders who achieved, who made difference in the lives of, you know, that Indian community. I think, you know, your Bharat Darshan started by visiting Raj Nivas, especially with the inspiration from Dr. Kiran Bedi ma'am. So thank you so much, ma'am, for the wonderful opportunity. We expect your inspiration and blessings, all the aspirants, the future leaders of this nation. And we also expect, ma'am, to be part of the United Nations organization before becoming President of India in future. Our prayers to the Almighty God to make difference. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you very much. You've been waiting for inspiration. You had a lot of questions. So the time is now. Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome to Raj Nivas. So you've all driven from Chennai?
Yes, ma'am.
And you came in buses?
Yes, ma'am.
I believe you had a little some problem on the way? All safe and fine?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, we were informed you were delayed because of that. You had some lunch or hungry? Hungry. So what's your plan for lunch?
Your speech.
No, you are hungry, I know. So what's your plan for lunch? You brought it along? Tiffin? It's in the bus or in the mess? Packed in the bus. And where is the bus?
Bus is some 100 meters away.
Why don't you eat your lunch first?
No problem.
You may be excited. Some may be hungry. Why don't you take a break? Have your lunch. I'll join you. Don't worry about me. I'm more concerned about you. So we won't extend too long because it is a lunchtime and some of you may be hungry and that you've driven also. So I won't take too long. I wouldn't, should not. So we'll stick to 15 minutes, okay? So that you can take a lunch, go back for lunch. But what are your questions? Are you all studying? Are you all graduates? Some may be postgraduates. And you are interested in public administration. That's why you are preparing for the civil services. So are you ready or are you preparing for the prelims or what's the stage? When is the prelims?
Some they have written the mains and waiting for the
okay. Great. So how many of you read the newspaper editorials every day? How many of you read it and then write it in your own words? You read it and then recall it in your own words. How many of you do it? You'll make it. So if you are taking some tips from here, number one, whichever article you like reading from the newspaper, whether it's any national daily or any article, and you like it, and you want to remember it, you want to make it your own, then the secret is reduce it in a few words yourself. Why am I saying this? It will help you recall, and it will also improve your expression, and it also an exercise in essay writing, and it's also remembering, it's memorizing important facts of that. What I was trained when I was growing up by my father was to read an editorial and translate it. Can you believe it? It's the toughest thing. And he used to say, translate it. And when you translate it in your own mother tongue or something, then you can never ever forget it. So if you want to make it what you're making it, that's the one of the keys, is read and transcribe and not copy. Put it aside. Let it go into your mind as to what it is. And if you like it, then produce it as it comes back. And then you can make a reference, what all did you forget? That means when you're writing it, or when you're reading it, mark it as you read, because what you like, just mark it. And then put it aside and then reproduce it. That will mean a whole class of learning. And that would also mean self-learning. It's self-education. A lot will be taught in the academies, but a lot will be self-learned, self-heard, self-acquired, self-analyzed, self-expressed. You understand? And you never know what comes in the papers. You never know. Because anything can come in the preliminaries, anything can come in general knowledge, and the essay writing, you will have started to write in a very concise way. It will also help you express in a very concise way. You will address, you'll communicate in writing very sharply, and you'll also speak very sharply, because you've started to learn to write briefly and in a summation. That's what is administration and communications is all about. Sometimes when you of course train yourself to be an interview, you will be already trained because you've already done it. This way you will, the ideas will flow in a very concise way. So too many things need not be. If you take this one thing today and read the editor, how many papers do you read? How many? Almost all? So pick up and then mark it. Keep the clipping as your library. Second thing, maintain your own library. It can be digital, it can be hard copy. So what you like, photograph it in your own camera, preserve it, go back to it again and again, and create your own digital library as a part of the album saved. Supposing you like, of course you're all reading about India. So you make an album in your iPhone, in the album, in that you create India album. India economy, India health, India water, India law and order, whatever subjects are coming. So when you open the file India, it'll come as it is. It'll become like a memory like this. You'll always be having it in your pocket. I have it in my pocket. My digital library is in my pocket through these albums. So whatever happens, what I like is a thought, is an inspiration. It's there. And like, for instance, how many of you read the Speaking Tree in Times of India? Only one reads it? Everybody must read it. There is a sacred column in almost every paper. Every national daily has some spiritual column. It's not about any conversion. It's about creating a better human being. So spiritual column, like the Speaking Tree, is a very interesting column. It's just about 1,000 words, but it gives you the thought for the day, the nutrition for the day. So you must nutrition yourself. It's like self-nutrition. Just as you have food for the stomach, you have food for the soul, you have food for the mind, you have food for the heart, the food for emotions, the food for better human being, the food to inspire, self-inspire. The key to our human life success is self-inspiration, self-nutrition, self-preparation. The word is continuously be self for the self. Self for the self. Because there's a self within which speaks to us. So if you keep nutritioning it, it speaks to you more. And when the self speaks to you more, it becomes a guidance, but you have to feed it. Keep nutritioning it. Okay? So I've told you three things. What did I say first? What was my first suggestion before the lunch break? Read the editorials. Second, reproduce it in your own words. And if possible, learn to translate even a paragraph. Even a paragraph would become that, becomes your vocabulary. You want to improve your vocabulary? So supposing there's a word which comes in, go to the Google dictionary, read the word, you learned a word. You improved your vocabulary, isn't it? So second, as I told you, read, write in your own words, and if possible, do translation, even if a paragraph. Third, read spiritual columns. These days, newspapers have food for thought. Newspapers don't only give you the economics and the political and the international news. It actually gives you all around. It all depends what pages you want to focus on. If somebody's a sports person, will go to sports page. Somebody's on the crime page, will go to the page 3. Somebody is on economic, you'll go to the economic page. You need all. In this examination, you will need all. So papers actually are giving you current up-to-date information. And of course, listening to the right kind of television news would be the BBC and the CNN. Do listen to it. Whether it's on the radio or it's on the television, find the time and listen to the news. Indian news repeats itself from the morning till night. Where the BBC and CNN doesn't, it gives you changing news. So you stay more current on what's happening around in the world. So these are very relevant issues. So Indian news is fine, but international news through the BBC and the CNN, these channels are helpful. I'm only giving you aid because you're preparing for the civils. So what will help you stay up to date and also very confident? Because books, once the book is published, it stops there. How do you continue to grow? By remaining in current affairs. Book is outdated till yesterday. What is happening today is not part of the book. That is only if you stay current. So what is taught, you have to continue to self-teach. Taught to self-teaching and self-learning. Okay, friends? I think that's good for the day. Any other three questions from you? I'll be happy to answer, and then you can take a break.
The former president of India gave a vision for the year 2020. And we are in this... former president of India, Dr. Kalam, gave a vision for the year 2020.
You're a faculty or a student?
Faculty.
Okay.
I'm Adil Beg. I'm teaching economics and international relations in KingMakers IAS Academy.
Very nice.
My question is, the former president of India, Dr. Kalam, gave a vision for this year, 2020. What could be a roadmap to achieve that vision, and what is your own ideas to achieve to make this India new India by 2030?
Yeah. I want a new man.
New man.
New woman. New human being. A thinking, creative human being. A new person. 2020 should mean new Indian. New Indian whose heart beats for his country. That's the Indian. And then an intelligent and educated Indian is not going to go to sleep. He will work. He'll energize the environment around. I think what 2020 should be, not only the economy. Economies all follow. It's the human being, the human element. When you have a good human element, why is Japan so brilliant? Why? Because every Japanese loves Japan. Every Japanese fulfills his or her responsibility. He may be interested in economics or information technology because the education means skill development and he will express. But the first thing is the human being. So you and I are not just going to make IAS, IPS. We've got to be creating better human beings who are in the IAS or the IPS or professors or entrepreneurs. The human being. A human being who doesn't cheat, a human being who doesn't lie, a human being who's not corrupt, a human being who doesn't burn property, public property, a human being who doesn't abuse. What we are doing, we are creating people who will lie, cheat, abuse, burn. That's not what India is 2020. So economy, etc., comes first. Come with better human characters. India is looking for characters. A man who would respect the dignity of a woman. A woman who would realize her potential. That's the humanity India needs right now. Everybody says, what's my responsibility? Not saying, what's my right? This is my right. No, no. What's my duty? What's my duty? I'll do my duty. I'll get my right if I do my duty. Because when I do my duty, I protect your right. When you do your duty, you're protecting my right. If we start looking at this as administrators, Indian administration would be so different. That's what this country needs today. Okay. Second question.
Good afternoon, ma'am. My name is Shivangi Mandal. I'm in my final year of undergraduate. In 1970s, we saw this great change wherein there was this first woman who became an IPS officer, which was path-breaking and changing. What do you think will be the vision, according to you, for women today? As in, if you would want, let's say, if you will picturize how a woman should be in India today, like talking about speaking right and, I mean, everything, how will you imagine that?
First, access to opportunities. If you have, like you are having access to an opportunity of learning. Now the challenge is yours. How less than anybody else? Your equal opportunities. How less than the men? Nobody. Is how you use your opportunities. What is the limitation? You limit your own self. Man or a woman, that's okay. But you're a great human being. You're a woman biologically, but you're a human being. So you must realize your potential to the maximum. You don't limit yourself. You think and plan for yourself. And you be what you're happy in. If you're happy at home, I think wonderful. If you're happy at work, wonderful. But if you're neither happy at home nor at work, then you've not realized your opportunities of the education which gave you. Any education which doesn't make you self-reliant, if it depends, you are all the time seeking approvals. May I? Should I? You're in doubt all the time. You're not a confident human being. So a woman is equal when she gets equal opportunities. So it now challenges hers, how she realizes her opportunity. So I would say begin with what you have and continue to grow. Yesterday we had school children from Isha Foundation, Coimbatore. Children, 12-year, 13-year-old, 14-year-old girl children, they came. And they're learning art, they're learning music, they're learning culture. They're learning all these things. I asked them, and they're in a school, boarding school there of the Isha Foundation, directly under the supervision of Sadhguru. And I asked them, I think I put it on the Twitter also, this little statement. I did. I asked them, what would you like to be? Because they're learning music, they're learning art. You see, they're not doing anything else. They're learning a lot of, they're not doing other things, which we, not that anything else, sorry. They're not doing other things which we're quite used to. So I asked them, so where do you see yourself going? What would you like to be? Do you know what the answer was? Guess. Guess what their answer was. Take a guess. Three guesses.
A good human.
Good? Okay. One. Two. Two. What was their answer? Can you guess? Aspiring for everything. Okay. Third. Any answer? Huh? Good citizen. Because I already gave you the cue. Because obviously they didn't say, oh, I want to be an IAS officer. Or I want to be a great engineer. Or I want to be the Indian's president. They said, continue to grow better. The word was continue to improve. They said, we shall continue to improve. My God. Continue to improve means what? Whatever you are today, to be better tomorrow. In whatever you happy it. So you don't say, I'll be millionaire, I'll be Bill Gates, or I'll be this. Well, that's it. That's okay. Perfect. But they knew, you can be a better Bill Gates. You can be a better Kalam. Whatever you, but continue to improve. And they laughed. We'll continue to improve. They all laughed. So improve, as an administrator, improve. That's our message. Continue to be a better administrator. Continue to be a better teacher. Continue to be a better parent. Continue to be a better human being. Continue to be a better woman. Continue to be anybody. Continue to improve. Okay, second. Third question, last question.
I've heard your greatness, ma'am. First thing, I'm very privileged to stand beside you and talk to you. I'm Vishal, ma'am. I'm doing LLB honors. So my question is, IPS is a service which is not preferred by any woman before you, ma'am. How did you feel being the first IPS officer in a male-dominated service? How did you feel? What was your biggest challenge that you could face as an IPS officer, as a first IPS officer?
I don't think women were afraid to join service earlier. They were scared away. They were sent away. They were sent away saying, how can you be? There are no more women in the IPS. So don't you know there are no women? And they were scared away. They got scared. They tried to do this with me too. And they tried to say, don't you think there's nobody? Are you sure you want to be the first? I said, I didn't know there were no women in the IPS before. But I want it. This is the service I'm very happy with. I want to serve my country in my uniform. And they said, no, you qualified for other central services as well. Would you like to join? I said, no, I only want this service because this is my first preference. So I don't want to get anything as a gift. I want something which I've earned and looked up to. So that's what I did. So it's not that women didn't want to join. I think they did want to join. They were scared away. So don't get scared. Had I got scared, I would have been somewhere else, but I wouldn't have been what I wanted to be, serving through. For me, uniform was the ultimate because I was a very fond NCC cadet as well. So I was loving my uniform from the age of 14 and I wanted to serve my life in my khaki and I did. So these are all choices we all make in our lives. All you have to do is be very careful in your choices and you fit in well and will you be happy in that choice? You always have a choice to make another choice. But then it could be a conscious choice and not a pushed choice. So we make our choices. I think art of making choices is also a skill. And that will happen when you inside are in alignment with your soul, with yourself, where you give time to yourself, you reflect on yourself, you are happy with yourself, you're contented with yourself, your needs are minimal, your need is more to give rather than take. See, when your needs is how much more can I serve rather than what can I get? So if your needs are like this, then there's just abundance for you because there's enough for you as a human being. If you're skilled, educated, you know what you want, you have the art, you continue to serve your way and be happy human being, right? So if you really, today's a great definition of success. Let me read it out. This is a very good piece I wrote in the Morning Nutrition and this was sped by some sannyasi. He said, increasing your material possessions is always growth. He said, increasing your materialistic possessions is called growth. That growth, if it is aided by ethics like discipline, honesty and norms, it is called progress. First thing he said, increasing your materialistic possessions is called growth. That growth, if aided with ethics like discipline, honesty and norms, it is called progress. That progress plus humanity, morality, spirituality is called success. So sometimes we think, oh, I've become an IAS officer, now I'm successful. If you're an IAS officer without integrity, you're a failure. You're a top class officer or a politician, but you are actually all the time in deceit. You're basically a failure, but you may be adorning a great position, but you're a failure within. And people, the moment you turn your back, they'll say, wow, acha hua chala gaya. So he says, this is what I've written in my Morning Nutrition, and this is spoken by Sadhu, and it is actually...
Basically, there is a misconception among us. You increase the turnover of your company, and people also tell you, you also start feeling that I have started becoming successful. Isn't it? Yes or no? No. There is a big difference between growth, progress, and success. If you increase the turnover of your company from 50 crores to 100, from 100 to 500 crores, it is called growth. It is not success. Let me redefine you the definition of success. Increasing your materialistic possessions in all ways is your growth. That growth, if it is aided by ethics, ethic means discipline, means honesty, means norms, it is called progress. So growth plus ethics is progress. And that progress plus humanity, morality, and spirituality is called success.
Did you hear it?
So again, I tell you, your turnover increase from 100 to 500 crores, you are not successful. You have just grown. Added by ethics, you have progressed. Added by moralities and spirituality in life is called success. Because even after having $100 million in your bank account and you are not happy from within, you have just grown, you have not been successful. Successful word itself includes stability, happiness, and peace along with all types of your growth and progress. Now rethink your goals. You just want to grow or be progressive or want to be successful?
Good. Yeah. So grow, progress, and? So choose. You're all grown anyway. You were a child before, right? And now you've grown, isn't it? You're not small anymore. And you all progressed because academically you all come from school to college. But you've yet to be successful. Once you acquire those qualities, he says. So your success is not yet there. You say, oh, I'm successful now. No, you've grown. You progressed. But you've yet to be successful as a human being. And that's exactly what I told you. India needs that kind of people who rate India not just in materialistic terms of economies, etc. Economy is growth. Having money is progress. But is it successful? Is India successful today? Is Indian youth successful? I don't think so. Because he or she still does not know what is success in real terms. So friends, that I think culminates the message which I also read this morning. And I search for such nutrition in the morning. People are such good people, they send it to me. Sometimes I get it on WhatsApp. Sometimes I pick it up on my Twitter. And then what I like, I share. Because what I share becomes mine too. It stays with me, but it also goes to wider environment spreading. So that's what I do as my small contribution to spread the concept of success in India to the friends, to my young men and women. So if you read something like on your own, I read as I do, you will also do what I do. What I do is not my monopoly. I also learnt it. So you learn and you share. Wish you all the very best in all your future endeavors, and may you succeed at that all you want to do. Thank you.
These are the All India Civil Services Aspirants preparing for the civil services examinations. So they are at a private academy which is training them. So you have those students. What is the name of your academy?
KingMakers IAS.
So this is a KingMakers Academy. It's called the KingMakers Academy. Or called the India Makers.